Hi, everybody. Welcome to My Big Tidy Up. My name is Dee Dee. Thanks for tuning in today. Now, today, here's what we've got on the menu. Today's menu is a massive bathroom declutter and transformation. But it won't be my bathroom because we are on the road today. It is a My Big Tidy Up on the go, and we are headed to the home of a senior who definitely needs some attention brought to their bathroom. Now, let me tell you, this bathroom may not be the biggest bathroom you'll ever see, but it's got a big amount of stuff in it that needs decluttered and organized. We need to make a better system so everything can be found and everything's accessible, and I'm just the gal to do it today. So without any further ado, let's hop in that car, let's buckle up, head down the road, and let's go get them tidy. Well, friends, here is our project today, and she's going to be a doozy, I have a feeling. But as I mentioned earlier, this is the bathroom of a senior citizen, which I like to refer to as seasoned citizens, because, you know, the older I become myself, the more I realize how very little I knew when I was younger. But anyway, back to the bathroom. This definitely will be a challenge because there are so many small items that need to be gone through, and I will be doing all of my work in this bathroom itself, so I'm not going to have a lot of room to work, but that's okay because I am definitely up for the challenge. Now, one thing that will be happening is a lot of decluttering. All of these shelves will be gone through, and this dresser. Now, the challenging thing about the dresser is it has items on top that need to be gone through, and every single drawer, well, it's full to the brim. But the good thing is that the three bottom drawers, the homeowner said all of these items can be removed and decluttered, which will open up three drawers for organized storage. Now, since this is going to be such a big project, I really wanted to have an exact kind of game plan put together, and I sort of do, but not completely. But I do know that since everything in the three bottom drawers are going, I know I'm going to do that first, so I have these drawers to help me sort items. Now, I have brought a few random containers that I had in my home, and the homeowner has a few random containers as well, but they're small, and I need big sorting containers because I have a big amount of things that need sorting. And yes, before we get started, there's no need for anyone to comment on how ungracefully I get down on the floor. I know, friends, I know. Anyway, so my plan for this first sort is to sort everything into three or four categories and keep it pretty general because I know there will be a lot more sorting and I'm going to have to break it down even more. But for now, I'm just going to divide everything up into groups like skin and body, medicines or medical, disposable items, and miscellaneous. And I have a feeling I'm going to have a lot of miscellaneous. Now, one thing that makes today's project a little bit different is that normally when I do a decluttering and organizing project, no matter how big or small, It goes in that order. I declutter everything, and then I organize what's left. But today, we'll be going back and forth, declutter, organize, because what I'm doing, I'm taking a drawer into the homeowner in the other room so that she can take her time, sort through everything, go through the drawer, see what she wants to keep, what she wants to get rid of, and I'll keep working here back in the bathroom. That way the homeowner isn't rushed, she has time to make good decisions, and I can keep the train rolling and I just keep working in the bathroom. And you know, I don't want her to feel like I'm rushing her. I want her to have her time. And so this video is probably gonna be all over the place, but that's okay, because you know what? The destination is the same place and we're gonna get there. Now, while the homeowner is sorting, I'm going to try to figure out how I'm going to utilize these metal shelves in here. Now, the homeowner did have these little clear containers that came with her refrigerator, and she's not using them in the refrigerator, so I think that's great. I think they're going to be super functional. I think she'll be able to see what's in them. They're small enough that she can handle them, but I've got to figure out where everything's going because I have a lot of stuff that's coming back into this room. Now, I just mentioned about these containers being functional, and you know, it got me to thinking about all of the My Big Tidy Ups I've done on the go. And every time I do a My Big Tidy Up on the go, I always ask the homeowner, what's your primary goal? Do you want a long-term solution, a short-term solution? Do you want to focus on it being functional? Do you want to focus on it being aesthetically pleasing? I always ask those type of questions. Now, I know we all love things to look beautiful and be aesthetically pleasing, but every time I have asked that question, they always tell me the same thing first. Functionality. And you know, I've organized for big families, small families, I've done business organizing, done young adults, and even some seasoned citizens. And every time, the answer is always the same. The first goal is functionality. And for this homeowner, it's the only goal. She just wants it functional. Well, I keep trying different things, but I think I'm getting closer to figuring out what I'm going to do. But this is a good stopping point because the homeowner has a drawer ready. So I think I'm going to go ahead and take these lotions. I've got some baskets, kind of random baskets scattered around that I can kind of use to help organize. And in this drawer, there's also some body sprays, and I found a couple of perfume bottles as well. And I think before the end of the day, they'll probably end up here on the wall since she's already got some perfumes up there, but we'll just have to see how everything pans out. Thank you. I do think this little metal shelving unit is going to be the best place for her perfumes and body sprays. I'm going to keep her perfumes on the left, and then I'm going to put all of her body sprays on the right, closest to the bathtub, so she can just reach over, grab those, spray those while she's still in the tub, or they'll be right there as she stepped out. Now the next item of business is the washcloth and hand towel issue. And at this point, I've already knocked them over 2 or 3 times. So it's probably obvious what the problem is. There are too many washcloths and towels right here by the door. However, the homeowner does want to keep some washcloths and hand towels right by the door so she can grab them as she comes in. So we've decided that she'll keep 10 of each out and the rest will go in one of the extra drawers. However, I can tell this is not going to be possible, so I'm going to have to ask her what she wants to do. Either we're going to have to declutter more towels, or we're going to have to give up another drawer. Well, the homeowner has spoken and she has made her decision, and it's the decision I was hoping she would make. We will keep 10 hand towels and 10 washcloths by the door for convenience. We will fill one drawer with extras, and all of the others, they are leaving the bathroom. They are gone. Although there are some big bath towels on the shelf by the dresser, I went ahead and asked the homeowner, would it be convenient if we put a few big towels on this little rolling drawer set? That way, she's able to lean forward and grab her towel instead of having to twist behind her to get one. So we are going to keep a few towels here as well. Even though I usually do all of the cleaning at the end, I did want to go ahead and clean this sink up a little bit because I feel like I was tromping into the kitchen every time I wanted to rinse out my cleaning cloth. And as I was wiping down the sink, I saw this blue folder and I wasn't even sure what it was. So I went and asked the homeowner, what is this? And she said, well, you can open it up and it lays over your sink. So if you're doing your makeup, you can put all your makeup items there. I didn't even know they made such a thing. Did you guys know about this? How convenient is that? Okay, back to the organizing part. I knew this video would be all over the place. Now, I do think the two shelves right by the toilet, those that are done, they're going to stay that way. Now, over here, I've got these tubs, and I've got one for extra oral hygiene, one for hair. I'll probably have one for cosmetics. And then I still do have a couple of these little containers left, but I don't know if I'm going to be able to use all of them because I may need them for the drawers. But I do want to have one of them at least, and I'm hoping that I can use it over here and that she can downsize everything and we can get everything on this side to fit in one of these containers, because I really don't have any other containers that size except this one right here that she keeps a lot of her cleaning products for. And I know this says denture tablets. If you guys haven't heard of this hack, this is a great hack. You can throw denture tablets into your tub, not your tub, your toilet. I guess you could try your tub, but you throw them in your toilet and they clean your toilet. She just wanted you to know she didn't have dentures. And if she did, she wouldn't be keeping her little tablets on the toilet. Okay, friends, status report. The decluttering has finally been completed. So at least now I know what I'm working with and I can finish loading the room. I do want to give the mirror a good cleaning and tidy up the floor, and then I'm going to call it a day. Well, here's what's leaving the bathroom today, and oh my goodness, it is a lot. 101 washcloths and hand towels. Yes, you heard that right. A tub of socks and undergarments, and since these are intimate apparel, I didn't go through and count each individual item, but I can tell you it's over 100. And this bag right here, hundreds of items, and it is so heavy, I'm probably going to have to drag it to the dumpster. But you know what? I'm really proud of this one, friends, because I know this one, it's going to make a difference in someone's quality of life. Well, Tidy Uppers, that's all for today. Thank you so much for traveling with me. I hope this video gave you some motivation, but I'm not talking about cleaning or decluttering or organizing motivation. I'm talking about motivation to just be kind or do something nice for someone today, and that someone could even be you. So please take care of yourself, and until I see you in the next one, stay tidy.